Today we are starting the program which is a C program that is for evaluating the postfix expression. We know that whenever we are having the operator after the operand, that is called the postfix expression. And how to solve that? We will use this particular program to solve it. First of all, I am going to execute this program. So we are compiling this program now. So compilation is successful. There is zero warning, zero error. Now I am going to execute it. So here we are having the execution window where we are having the program of evaluating the postfix expression, and it is asking for a postfix expression. So we are entering one expression AB plus. There are the values we are not passing. Now it is asking for the value of A. Let us suppose I am passing the 4. Value of B, let us suppose 3. Now the answer is given on our screen, which is 7. So that is how the program will work. Now we are going to see the code of this program. Now we are going with the program. So here it is asking, first of all, that these are two lines, double slash, that means it is a comment, program to evaluate the postfix expression. We are importing two libraries, hash include stdio, which is standard input output header file for printf and scanf functions, then hash include math.h, which is for the math functions. Then these are the three function prototypes. That means these are the three functions available. One is void evaluate, means there is a function which is void evaluate, which is going to evaluate the expression. Then void push float f. So that means inside the push we are going to pass on some element, and that float element will be entered onto the stack. Then float pop. So we are going to call the pop function. With the help of that we will get the return one element, float type. So these are the three prototype of the functions. Then we are having char q20. So we are having a character type array which is having q20. So let us suppose that this one is the array which is the named as q, and here we are having the value starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to so on till 19, because the size of q is 20. So size is given as 20. Now afterward we are having the next thing, float type array stack 20. We know that we are representing the stack with the help of array. So this one is the stack 20. Now we are taking one more array which is representing the stack. So this one is a stack. So we have taken this as a stack where we will store some elements, and it will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 up to 19, because the size of stack is also given as 20. So from 0 to 19 stack size will be there. Now int top is equal to -1. So here the top is pointing to -1. We know that top point to the top element. So top is pointing to -1. That means there is no element here right now onto the stack. Now afterward we are having the main function, which is void main. Inside that we are having the printf welcome to program of evaluate postfix expression. So the message will be displayed on the user screen that this program is for evaluation the postfix expression. Afterward we are having the printf enter postfix expression. So now on the user screen there is one more message, enter the postfix expression. Now let us suppose that user has entered the postfix expression. We are assuming the expression is AB plus. So that's what we are taking. Let us suppose this A, B and plus, that is taken. Now gets Q. Now whatever the user has entered, gets is going to take that string and put into the Q. So that means inside the Q we are putting this one. So A, B plus is now the part of this Q. Now evaluate. So evaluate function is called. So now we are going to call the evaluate function. So evaluate function will run now. So now scroll down to the evaluate function. We are scrolling it. So this one is the evaluate function on which we will perform the operation. So from main program we have called this evaluate function, and inside the evaluate function we are having few variables of float type, float A, B and value. So here we are taking few variables just like A and B. These are the float type variable, and one is value 20. That means we are going to take one more array which is of 20 size, named is value. So now we are having this array which is named as value, and this value will start from 0, 1, 2, 3 and go till 19, because we can see that this value is having the 20 size. Now afterward we are declaring one variable I. This variable I is basically for running the for loop, so that we are taking here. Now for I is equal to 0, so I is starting from 0 and it will run until qi. Qi means this q we are talking about not equal to slash 0. We know that whenever we are having any of the string we are pasting, because we have used the gets function, so a, b plus, after that the last thing will be slash 0, which is the ending character. So until we are going to the slash 0, this for loop is going to work and increment. And now understand one thing, here we are having if qi greater than equal to 65 and qi less than equal to 92, and we already know that the range from 65 to 92, these are nothing but the capital alphabets. So from A to Z, we are having this range. That means if you are entering some of the expression like AB plus, so it will find that the capital letter. If the letter is finding, then obviously it will give us the this one. This will come inside. So it is first going to see on Q0. We are going on Q0 because the value of I is 0. So here the first one is A. Now this A is falling under this range. So it will come down F flush STDIN. This is going to clear the buffer if some earlier value is placed. So buffer will be cleaned. Then printf slash n, enter the value of percentage C. So now percentage C QI. Now understand one thing, that QI means that variable A. So on the screen there will be the message, please enter the value of A. Now user is going to give the value of A. Let us suppose that user has given 7. So it will take 7, or we can take the values which we have taken into the input like 4. So the value of A is given as 4. Now afterward scanf percentage F and value I. So inside the value I. So value I is 0. So here the value is placed. So 4 value is placed. So this 4 is corresponding value to the A. Now this is done. Afterward we'll go back again checking the condition. Is QI equal to slash 0? No, QI is not slash 0 because I is already incremented. Now QI is not slash 0. Q1 is the B. Again coming down, checking the condition, is it some alphabet? Yes, it is alphabet because this one is B. B is alphabet. Again come down, flushing the clear value, again asking for the new alphabet value. So here it will ask for the value of B. Now let us suppose user has entered the value of B as 3. So what is going to happen? Scanf percentage F and value of I. Now value of I, we know that the I is 1. So value 1. The value we have entered is 3. So this 3 value is corresponding to the value of B. That means the value of A is 4, value of B is 3. We are having two different arrays here. Q is taking the expression and value is taking the corresponding values. Again, it will go back. I will be incremented. Then here it is checking, is the Q done? Means here, is anything done? Slash 0. Slash 0 is not there, because Q2 is plus. It will come down and checking, is that plus falling under the range between 65 to 92? No, it will not fall because plus is not an alphabet. Again, it will go back. Again, I plus plus. Now the value of I is 3. So now it is on Q3, which is slash 0. Is it not slash 0? It is slash 0. So it will come out. So this for loop is doing nothing, but this for loop is taking all the alphabets and storing their corresponding values. So here the value of A is 4 and value of B is 3. And these values are stored into the value array. Now we are scrolling down to the next for loop. Before going to the for loop, we are going to learn this push and pop function, because these functions will be used by the for loop. So here we are having void push float f. That means once the push function is called and there is some floating value there, then what is going to happen? First of all, we will say top plus plus. Let us suppose that top here is on minus 1. Now what will happen? Top plus plus. So top will go here, and stack top means stack 0, stack top. So stack top will be f. F means whatever the element I am passing. Let us suppose I am passing element 9. So 9 will be placed here. So that is the pop is going to, push is going to happen. Now afterward we are having the next function, which is float pop. So float pop means once I call the pop function, something will come in return of float type. So here what we are saying, return stack top minus minus. This minus minus is the post decrement operator. So here first of all this will be performed, stack top. Let us suppose that here I am calling the pop function. So what is going to happen? Stack top. Now the top is pointing to 0. So stack top means this 9 will come out. And what is going to happen afterward? Minus minus. So top minus minus. Top will be going back to the same position, which is minus 1. So this is how the push and pop function will work. Now I'm going back to the remaining for loop. Now we are going back to the for loop. So this was the for loop which was remaining. Till now we are having a queue. In that queue array we are having AB plus, and correspondingly we are having a value array where we are having the 4 and 3. Then afterward we are assuming, so 4i is equal to 0. Now I was earlier 3, again it is going to the 0, and it is saying I less than qi or qi not equal to slash 0. So any of the condition can work, but this condition is better. We don't require I less than something. So qi not equal to 0, until the qi not equal to 0 slash 0, this will work. That means the same thing, until we get this slash 0 means ending character, we are going to work. So we are going down because here q0, it is not the ending character. We are coming down. If qi greater than equal to 65 and qi less than equal to 92, again we are talking about this thing, means 65 to 92, these are from A to Z. Whenever we are taking any alphabet from A to Z, what we are doing? We are pushing the value I. If I get the first alphabet, I will push the value. Remember this thing, I am not pushing the alphabet, I am pushing the value. So here, first of all, in Q0, we got A. And A is the part of 65 and 92 because the sky value of A is matching with this one. So it will come inside and push value I. So correspondingly A, we are having the value at 0th position, which is 4. So this 4 we are going to push, and we know that whenever we are going to push a value, top is now changed. So this is the new value of top. So top is now pointing to 0. Afterward, else part will not run because we have already worked with the if part. So we are going back now. We are going back I plus plus. So the value of I is incremented, and that is 1. Again it will come here and check qi not equal to slash 0. So qi and I is 1. So q1 is b. The b is not equal to slash 0. So it will come down. It will come and again it will check if qi greater than 65 and qi less than 92, means is that b is the alphabet, is in that range? Yes, B is alphabet. So obviously we will come down. Again, push value I. We are not pushing the B, we are pushing the corresponding value. So B, here we are having the value which is 3. So push value I. Value I is 1. So 3 we are going to push. So inside the stack, we are having one more value which is 3, and the top is now incremented to next. So top is now 1. So here else part will not run. It will go back again and checking the condition. First of all, the I is incremented and the value of I is 2. Now the value of I is 2. So here we are coming back and checking that qi not equal to slash 0. So qi and I is 2. So q2 is plus. So plus is not the part of this one. these values. So what will happen? First of all, we are checking the above condition. It is not slash zero, so it will come down. Then afterward, it will check whether it is an alphabet from A to Z, means this range. No. So this part is not running this time. It will come to the else part. So else part is going to run. What we are going here, B is equal to pop. So pop means take out element. From the stack, we are taking element. This is the element we are taking out. So this one, 3, we are taking out and we are giving the name, which is B. So the value of B is 3. Now afterward, the top will be pointing to 0 because pop will decrement the top and this value is removed. Afterward, we are saying A is equal to pop. So again, we are taking one more element and giving to the A. So this element is 4 and giving to A. So this element is removed. Again, the value of top is now going to minus 1. So these values are not working because already the top is decremented to the minus 1. And stack is empty. So we are having two values. The value of A is 4, value of B is 3. These values we have taken. Now, if QI is equal to power, do we have the power? No. But if we have the power, then power function will work. Else if QI equal to slash, do we have the QI? QI means this one plus. Do we have this one as slash? No. So this part will not work. If we are having the slash, then divide operator will work. But here we don't have. Else if QI is equal to star, we don't have the star. But if we have the star, then this multiply will work. Else if QI equal to plus, do we have plus? Yes, we have the plus. So plus and plus matching. So now here we are saying push A plus B. So what is A? A is 4, B is 3. A plus B, 4 plus 3, that is 7. So now we are going to push inside the stack, that is 7. So 7 will come here. This is the new 7 which will come. And top is now incremented to the 0. So now the top is coming. So we are having only one element into the stack, which is 7. Now afterward, we are having else if. Obviously, we have worked with one else if, then other will not work. But yeah, we are checking for as per the condition. QI equal to minus. Maybe if we have the minus, then minus will work. But yeah, this will not work. Obviously, we have worked with the one. This is only for the understanding. Afterward, it will come out. Then it will be going back to the I plus plus. So I is incremented. And now the value of I is 3. Now, again checking the condition, Q3 and Q3 is slash 0, which is the terminating condition. So what will happen? It will directly come out to the next line. It is out of the for loop. So here what we are saying, here we are mentioning that printf answer after solving the postfix expression. So after solving the postfix expression, which was AB plus, and we know that AB plus, here the value of AB was 4, 3 plus. And we know that the answer should be 7. So that is nothing but the stack top. So stack top is what? Stack top is 7. So the answer of this expression is 7. So that is how we have solved the postfix expression. We have evaluated it.